The Life of Kaede Kayano, Assassination Classroom. Kaede Kayano, known previously as Akari Yukimura, is a student in Class 3E of Kunugigaoka Junior High School, taught by Koro-sensei. She's one of Nagisa Shiota's best friends and is, by her admittance, currently in love with him. Welcome to the Imagi. In today's video, we're going over the life of Kaede Kayano. Before we begin, we publish a new video every day, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. Background. Akari Yukimura is the younger sister of Aguri Yukimura, who, before joining Kunugigaoka, was a famed prodigal actress who went by the stage name of Haruna Mase. At some point during her career, her manager suggested that she take some time off, which she did. Eventually, people stopped recognizing her altogether, and she continued her time as a regular middle school student. Akari's relationship with her elder sister was loving and positive, to the point that she would tease Aguri about who she was infatuated with as of late. She advised Aguri to end her relationship with her fiancé, Kotaro Yanagisawa, after deducing that he had a sinister personality underneath his charms, due to her experience with directors in her acting career. The two sisters agreed to catch up properly after Aguri mentioned getting some time off the next day, though Akari had the last word, requesting to know everything about the man that Aguri was into. One day, Akari was wandering outside the research facility her sister helped out at, and witnessed an explosion take place. Because of her small stature, she was able to navigate her way through the rubble to get to Aguri. When she finally reached her sister, she saw her bleeding with a tentacled creature that would soon later become Koro-sensei leaning over her body. The creature sped off, soon after leaving a note addressed to Aguri's relative telling them where to find him. Akari hurried to her now dead sister, and while mourning for her, she came across the tentacle cell liquid. She took her sister's research home and began researching the tentacles, studied what they were for, and simultaneously planned her revenge as well as her ultimate act. She even transferred to Kunugigaoka under the fake alias of Kaede Kayano, which was the name of a one-shot character she once played, and got herself put into Class E by destroying some of Chairman Asano's valuable possessions. Soon after, she injected herself with the cells and dyed her black hair green. At some point, not long after, she met Nagisa and decided that he was the perfect candidate to conceal her and place her as one of the background characters. She commented on his long hair and styled them into his signature pigtails. She introduced herself to him, and their friendship began. As a 3E student. In the first chapter, Kayano was the one who asked the target teacher what name they should refer to him as. He tells her that they can decide. After Terasaka's failed assassination attempt, she says the name she thought of for the teacher, Koro-sensei, meaning unkillable or invincible teacher. In spite of her main character status, she tends to remain in the background, being geared mainly towards logistical support. During the Kyoto school trip, Kayano and Yukiko Kanzaki were kidnapped by rogue high school students. At that time, she learned about Kanzaki's secret before they were rescued by their group and Koro-sensei. She devised an assassination attempt purely based on her love of pudding. Although the attempt was unsuccessful, her classmates were impressed at how straightforward and well thought out the plan was. During the following arc, she remains occupied on logistical and supportive roles, being Team A's only non-combat member during the fight with the Reaper. Furthermore, she helped the class during the school festival and the play. Time for a storm. Kayano's time. Along with Nagisa, Kayano was tasked with storing away the props from the play Class E had recently made, with Koro-sensei quickly offering to help them. In the shack, after reminiscing her time spent with the class, she reveals two black tentacles sprouting from the nape of her neck. She suddenly attacks Koro-sensei, stunning him. She promptly states her love for him, along with her desire to kill him. She then attempts to kill Koro-sensei with a pitfall trap, filled with anti-sensei material at the bottom of it, forcing him down with her tentacles. Her attempt is thwarted once he uses his energy beam to blow up a part of the wall to escape, Kayano being unable to stop him after instinctively recoiling in defense. The sound from the explosion alerts the class, who arrive and are shocked at the revelation of Kayano having tentacles, Itana in particular. She informs Koro-sensei of her current name being fake, and gives him an obvious hint of her true identity and connection to him. After promising to kill him the next day, she exits the school ground completely indifferent to her classmates and their reactions. She arranges for Koro-sensei to duel her at Kunugigaoka Park at night to fulfill her promise dressed in a skirt and ankle boots despite the cold weather. She reminisces how she managed to blend herself in with ease, using Nagisa as a cover to hide her bloodlust while he stands out more, and accuses Koro-sensei of murdering her sister. Kayano also explained how she discovered the research her sister was involved in and implanted herself with tentacles as part of her ultimate plan to kill him. Kayano also claimed that the persona she had for most of the school year was a fabrication. She then starts fighting Koro-sensei, who was barely able to keep up with her speed. As Kaino was quickly being consumed by her tentacles feeding off her bloodlust, Koro-sensei used what little energy he had to spare to inform the class to distract Kaino long enough for him to remove her tentacles. To do this, he would expose his ultimate weak spot, his heart hidden behind his crescent moon tie. While someone tries to stop her, Kaino's tentacles do manage to strike him in the heart, though he survived the attempt. Simultaneously, Nagisa intervenes and approaches his friend. Using Irina's seductive kissing technique, as well as his bloodlust, Nagisa negates Kaino's bloodlust and kisses her on the lips. The bloodlust from her eyes change to an expression of shock and surprise, and Kaino is rendered unconscious after 15 hits, you know, kisses. Koro-sensei then removes her tentacles. She soon wakes up, returning to her normal self, explaining that as she got to know her teacher and classmates more, her initial will to kill him gradually dropped and began thinking that there were perhaps more to the story than she knew. The students forgive her, and she asks that she no longer needs to put up the acting charade. Realizing that the situation has changed and that Shiro was watching the fight the whole time, Koro-sensei began telling the true story of how he became to be what he is now, with the whole class, including Kaino, listening on. After hearing his side of the story, Kaino and the whole class realized that hearing his past, plus the 9 months they spent with him, made the act of killing him all the more harder and frightening. Throughout the winter break, Kaino, with her hair grown back to its original length, spent her time recovering from her tentacle experiences in the hospital. On the day before the start of the final semester, she was visited by Nagisa, Sugino, Okuda, and Kanzaki, who updated her on the inactivity since hearing their teacher's past. Kaino brushes off Nagisa's apology for kissing her as simply that she was grateful to him for saving her life. However, when they leave, Kaino flails about at the thought of Nagisa kissing her and bemoans the fact that she has to continue acting as a friend. A new purpose. At the start of the third and final semester, Nagisa called the class together and proposed that instead of killing Koro-sensei, they try to find a way to save him. Kaino and several others agreed with this, though Karma, Nakamura, and Terasaka were against this. Koro-sensei intervened following a fight between Nagisa and Karma and proposed the class to play a paintball match to settle the dispute. Kaino joins the blue team, the team wanting to save Koro-sensei and to Nagisa's relief, stating that she wants to honor her sister's wish to save him, and privately thought to herself that falling for assassins seemed to run in the family. Sometime after the match begins, Kaino witnesses Hinata Okuno take out Hinano Kurahashi and pursues her. Her speed and ability to keep up with her quarry surprises Okuno, which Kaino attributes to her physical training as part of her acting career. But Kaino is shot from behind by Kimura just before she could eliminate Okuno. Okuno helps the defeated Kaino up and part on good terms. When the war boils down to between Nagisa and Karma, Kaino believes that for Nagisa to truly win and unite the class, he needs to meet Karma's melee challenge head on. She and the class eventually witness Karma surrendering and Nagisa winning the battle. After painstaking research, the class discovers that there was a solution to save Koro-sensei, namely that Okuda's poison in the first semester would reduce the already small chances of their target blowing up in March. Valentine's time. She's discovered by Karma and Ryu Nakamura hiding a piece of chocolate under her desk. Her attempt to pass it off as obligation chocolate fails when Karma shows her a picture of her and Nagisa kissing, completely flustering her. Karma and Nakamura decide to help Kaino out and begin spying on other classmates. To prevent Koro-sensei on spying on Kaino and Nagisa alone, she gives Karma a picture of Aguri Yukimura in a swimsuit and chocolate on her behalf, which works well enough to be used for an actual assassination. Kaino manages to get Nagisa alone, but her nervousness makes her ask him what career path he might pursue. While Nagisa was evasive, she deduces him to become a teacher based on his admiration of Koro-sensei as a schoolteacher. When he sees Koro-sensei perched from afar, his straightforward focus reminded Kaino of why she fell in love with him, and why she didn't feel empty and hollow after the loss of her sister and pursuit for vengeance. With this, she presents Nagisa her bar of chocolate, thanking him for always being by her side ever since she joined Class E, and walks away vowing to support him. Assassination time, second hour. 1 week before the March deadline arrives, Koro-sensei is trapped in the mountain classroom by the government's Earth Shield and would be destroyed by their satellite weapon on the final day. Kaino and the class were kidnapped by an elite mercenary group and held in confinement by the government for their safety. On the final day, the students were able to escape with Irina's help. Penetrating the army perimeter at the base of the mountain, the class efficiently took out the mercenaries that kidnapped them, who severely underestimated the students' abilities. The class's reunion with Koro-sensei is interrupted by the arrival of Shiro and the Second Reaper, the latter becoming a tentacled monster. Unlike Kaino and Itona as former tentacle users, Number 2 was completely compatible as he started attacking Koro-sensei in a ferocious manner. Shiro himself joins the fight, injecting himself with a tentacle seed after Kaino calls him out on always letting his pawns do the dirty work for him. Koro-sensei is then forced to protect the students after Number 2 is ordered to attack them. With her teacher unable to heal himself and counterattack, Kaino fires a shot at Number 2 and damages one of Number 2's tentacles thanks to the kinetic vision she retained after losing her tentacles. Despite Koda-sensei's objections, she regrets having the class learn the truth and deny them the fun times they enjoyed. Her attempt to strike, however, is interrupted as she is impaled through the chest in the same manner as her deceased sister. Seeing this, Koda-sensei turns pitch black and re-engages his former apprentice, while Kaino is carried off by Nagisa. After both Shiro and the Second Reaper are defeated by Koda-sensei, he reveals to the class that he caught and preserved the majority of Kaino's spilled blood and damaged cells. He commences operating on her at a microscopic level, replacing the cells to their original position. He also gets blood donations from Class E students with AB blood types to help with blood transfusions, notably Karma and Ituna. After this, he defibrillates her, successfully restarting her heart and bringing her back to life. Although upset that her ripped clothes had not been mended first, she was still grateful to Koda-sensei for saving her life. In this final moment before the execution, Kaino positioned Koda-sensei's head on her lap before Koda-sensei called for a final attendance and is finally assassinated 1 minute before midnight. The whole class wailed in grief as their beloved teacher and target departed them forever. Aftermath. After the graduation and assassination of Koda-sensei, Kaino returns to the acting profession as Haruna Mase. Her parkour skills gained from her time in Class E have enabled her to perform her stunts during filming and became popular from starring in her morning dramas in her own right. A whole 7 years has passed before she was able to pay a visit by sneaking out during a break of one of her shooting sessions to visit the old Class E building to pray for Koda-sensei and her elder sister. There, she was found by some of her former classmates. Kaino joins them to repair the class back to its former glory, but then they wonder how they'll be able to look after the premises because, you know, jobs and life in general begin to interfere. Kaino privately thinks to herself that she has one person in mind who can put the building to good use in the near future. When Sumire Hara asks Kaino whether she's kept in contact with Nagisa, Kaino, although blushing, merely replied that he's probably a little bit more focused on his career path at present. Did you enjoy our video? Be sure to check out these other great videos from the Imagi, and make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.